annoyed that I had went there just to see that girl lose. I'm gonna tell you this right now. I was so annoyed, and she didn't even like make it far. That's something that really made me bad.
Now, before we get into this video, I want all of you to keep in mind that I am telling this story based off of my memory. It's been over a year since I attended this pageant, so if you really care to know more information, please look it up on your own. I'm going to have some resources down below if you'd like to look it up. Also, this is all my personal opinion. You do not have to agree, and I will be adding clips from different pageants to give you more context.
What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we are going to be talking about when I attended a pageant. Ignore that crazy ass laugh, because I'm just thinking about like how in the world could I forget this experience. I feel like the experience was so annoying, so damn unfair, that I just blocked it out from my mind completely. Okay, so before we get into all of that, this video is sponsored by Sunbur Hair. This is their lovely body wave I got popping, and this is my second time working with them, and this is my second time having their body wave. I did something different. Let me know, like, how do y'all feel? Because, like, I was tired. I'm kind of tired of the sew-ins and the wigs. I'm still gonna do them, of course, but it's like, I wanna do some more stuff like this, you know? Like, braided hairstyles with, like, you know, the hair sewed in somewhere. Like, my ponytail was sewed in. I can't even take this out, y'all. Like, I really do like it. I love this ponytail. I like the fact that I chose to do something different. Let me know, do you want more hairstyles like this, less hairstyles like this? Let me know. I must say, of all the companies that I've worked with and all the body wave hair that I've had, this has to be the best and my most favorite body wave hair. Even though it does tangle a tad bit and it does shed a tad bit, the density is just there. There's no gray hairs, there's no blonde hairs. It feels so nice. It just has like a really nice quality to it, a really nice feel.
All the body wave hair.
So if you want the details on this hair, go down below in the description or in the pinned comment down below. Okay, yeah, so attending a pageant for the first time. Now, I attended Miss Teen New Jersey USA last year. I believe it took place November 16th. I don't remember where. It was somewhere in New Jersey, clearly, right? I remember I didn't drive. Santiago drove because I still had anxiety at the time when it came to driving. We were invited by a specific person's parent. I can't tell you guys where, how, whatever, just in case the person comes across my video and decides to get upset saying that I'm talking shit, whatever the case may be. So yeah, we're gonna keep all of that beside. It's just, no, I was there, Santiago was there, and Santiago drove my car there, therefore I don't remember where it was, but you guys can easily look up where it was. Okay, I honestly believe that this was the most annoying thing ever, and I can't believe that I completely forgot that I attended this pageant. Now you haven't told this story sooner, okay? Let me just say, y'all who've been here before, y'all already know I do like pageants. I think they're cute, you know. I think that they really do help a lot of people out with their self-esteem. I think that they build character for certain people, okay, for certain kids. However, after going to this pageant over a year ago, I'm just like, wouldn't be me, and I wouldn't go to another one, because that was a complete utter waste of my goddamn time. Okay, from what I remember, there's about what, 3 to 4 segments. There's an opening number where they do this little dance situation. Cheesy. I don't like it. Then I believe after that is like active wear. And then after the active wear is, I believe, the evening gown round.
In the evening gown competition with Kansas.
Oh, And then after that, that's pretty much it. Now, you would assume that this event only took an hour. No, it was a good like 2 to 3 hours. And honestly, like, that was the most annoying situation ever. It was just like, I expected there to be a fucking talent show, something, because it was like, why is this shit so damn long, okay? So let's go for the beginning, okay? So first, the line be OD long. They told us to be there at a specific time, but I don't even think it started at that specific time because the line outside was so goddamn long. So clearly, you know, you go in, you give your ticket, you sit down, and it took place in a hotel ballroom type situation, which is where most pageants take place. It was really nice, it was set up really nice, but the amount of time they took to just announce everything and the amount of like dragging out they did for this was just absolutely unnecessary. So when they first start, they announce all the judges. You would think that when they're announcing the judges, they're just like, hey, we have judged this, that, and the third. No! They took, I kid you not, at least 30 to 45 minutes to announce all of these goddamn judges. They had to be about 3 or 4 judges. I think it was like 3. And I was just like, why? Like, they spend all of this time telling you the biography, the accolades, whoever shits pees that had diarrhea this morning, they tell you all of that, bro. All of that for each judge. And then they do the same thing for the host. That takes a good 30 minutes, bro. Like, don't nobody, like, I'm not gonna say I don't care, but at the end of the day, this is for the kids. I don't care about what you do, how you do it, whatever. Like, clearly, I'd love to know if you are qualified to do what you're doing. Like, you know, like, if you are qualified to be judging girls on their poise and personality and if they should be representing the state. But the funny part about it is, only about like one of those judges or maybe 2. Shit, even the host, like, none of them had anything to do with pageantry. Like, they just were notable people. Like, I don't know, like, if that's the case, can I judge a pageant? Like, can someone invite me to judge a pageant or something? Like, I don't understand. Like, I don't know shit about pageants. All I do is watch Toddlers and Tiaras. I attended this one pageant and that's it. I don't know. I'm like, were y'all just inviting people to come to this shit just so they would buy tickets or something? Like, I don't understand. Like, it's just whatever. That's none of my business. I was shook because I'm just like, that is a lot of like girls. Like, how do they pick who's going to win? How do they narrow it down? Like, I really truly want to know. Like, how do they narrow this down? Because that's a lot of people to go through. And from what I understand, there's an interview that takes place before the pageant as well. So it's just like, how in the world are y'all picking these people? Now, what I found really, really interesting was there was a segment where the girls introduced who they were. I believe this was the evening gown. No, it couldn't have. It was sometime in the beginning because whoever me and some of y'all were there for, this girl didn't make it past shit. And I was so upset because they had the audacity to make this announcement, talk about some.
Oh, well, you know, even if your girl doesn't win, please make sure you stand by and support the other children.
I don't care about the other kids. I didn't come here for the other kids. It's about y'all are the damn kids. Like, I honestly would have much rather hear 100 bios of those 100 something kids than hear one bio of one of them crappy ass adults. I don't care about what you done did. I didn't come here to see you. I came here to see beautiful girls in beautiful gowns with poise. I didn't come here to hear you talk about all this gaga. Like, it was just, oh my God, I was just so annoyed. I was like, damn, are all patterns like this? Cause I'm over it.
Woo, child. As I was editing this, I happened to stumble upon this on the Miss Teen New Jersey USA, whatever it's called, pageant website, right? And y'all, take a look at this. It says each contestant will compete in 3 equal phases of preliminary competition: interview, swimsuit, or activewear, depending, and evening gown. The results from these preliminary phases of the competition are added up, and the contestant with the highest composite scores becomes semifinalist. The number of semifinalists will be determined by the total number of contestants in the competition, and is typically between 10 and 15. Scoring is based on the following: interview, swimsuit, evening gown. You guys could look into that. Now, okay, so if you're telling me that basically the finalists, well, the semifinalists are chosen mainly in due to the, you know, interview and in combination with all that other stuff. Think about it. Okay, so we don't see the interview, and most of the time throughout this entire competition, these girls do not talk. Like, I kid you not, like, the only time you get to hear them talk is like that little Q&A section when it's like towards the end. So I'm confused as hell. I'm like, wait, what? So technically the audience doesn't really get to see or get to know any of the contestants. Like, you're just there looking at them look pretty. Like, that's really all it is. And then it's really interesting. It's like, okay, so the swimsuit or the activewear as well as the evening gown factors in. But I mean, like, that's a lot of people to judge at the same time. Like, a lot. And not everyone makes it to that point. So is it like that they chop them down when it gets to that point, or they already know who they want to win? This is just a conspiracy, y'all. It's just a conspiracy, and I feel like it's a little interesting. I feel like from the interview point, they already know who's going to win, who they want to win, etc. That's just how I feel about it, because that's just a little strange. Like, there's no way you can like chop it down that much in such a short amount of time. Like, the competition moves very quickly. There's not like any real breaks. There's like a short intermission, but like between each round, there's not really any long breaks in order for them to really sit down and deliberate who's done very well in a particular section. That's a lot of girls, so I'm just saying.
But okay, whatever. Honestly, I went to go find a drink in the hotel. Like, I had to go locate the ball, and then I came back and I supported the other kids. I was supporting this one girl. She was an African girl. She was so fucking beautiful. She was, And I think she got like third runner up, which was fucking bullshit, bogus, caca. But whatever, that's neither here or there. I realized about this pageant, and I think, I don't know how this works for other pageants, was I don't know. I just find it very interesting because there was a segment where basically all the girls introduced themselves, and they basically went and they were saying like, oh, this girl enjoys this, this girl does that. Like, they basically were telling key important parts of each girl. However, I realized most of those girls, they didn't outline anything. It was just,
she likes to study. She likes to play with her dog, Rover.
But then for certain girls, it was like,
she's part of the National Honor Society. She enjoys doing community service, and she plays basketball.
Why is it that certain girls had like a whole full-blown fucking bio, and the other ones had one fucking sentence? Now, I was thinking that the entire time, but I was like, it can't be. It really can't be. And it's crazy because like when it came time for the girl that we were supporting, they were just like, they said something extremely generic, like, she likes to do her homework. It was something like extremely generic. I can't remember exactly what it was, but it was just like, that's all she told them? That's all you told these people? That you like to do your homework? Yeah, that, popcorn, no, I don't take that. I don't take that, that's bull. And it's funny because now that I think about it, like, all the girls that had like a legit bio, like the girls that they actually like sat there and told their whole damn accolades, were the ones that made it to like the top five, I believe. And it was very funny to me. I'm just like, do y'all pick who's gonna win from the interviews that y'all do previously? Do y'all like, I was so annoyed that I had went there just to see that girl lose. I'm gonna tell you this right now, I was so annoyed, and she didn't even like make it far. That's something that really made me bad. Like, they just was chopping girls down. Like, they went from like 100 to like 20 to like 10 to like 5, and then that was it. Like, it was really, really like, they was just cutting girls out. Like,
our final lady moving into the top five tonight is Alabama.
I was just like, dang, this cutthroat. This real, real cutthroat. Like, I was shook. Honestly, I just find it crazy. Like, winner gets a whole heap of shit. Like, they do. They get a whole heap of shit.
Now, I know y'all thought that I was over-exaggerating, but literally, this is the list of prizes that the winner does get. You can refer to the link down in the pinned comment down below to literally go through this, because I'm not about to sit here and read all of that.
I find it crazy how, like, all those girls spend all that time, all that money, and they don't get nothing. Like, I don't know, like, I see a lot of kid pageants where, like, you know, the kids will get a, you know, a bag of toys, or they get to pick a toy from a section. And, like, I feel like they should get something. Shit, a sticker, an apple, like, what? Yo, these dresses alone cost thousands of dollars sometimes. So it's just like, why? No, like, that's probably one reason I would probably never do a pageant, because you're not about to have me out here doing all this extra shit. I don't win, and I don't get nothing. And I know some people are gonna be like,
oh, well, you get the experience. You get to meet a lot of new people.
Fuck that shit. I could meet people on my own. I'm not gonna spend thousands of dollars to meet new goddamn people. I could go to Starbucks for that. I don't like Starbucks. I could go to I kind of like McDonald's. I go to McDonald's for that.
Now, I forgot to mention this. There is a final round where they ask the final five contestants some questions. It's like a Q&A style type of situation. One of the judges asks each contestant a question. That's literally the only time you get to hear these girls talk. And it's only about five of them that you ever get to really hear talk, except for the introduction portion.
That pageant was boring. I literally had to go find the bar. I had to go cop a drink because I'm just like, what? Like, you know, I didn't want to be an asshole to the kids that was there, you know, that was already in the pageant. So I was like, you know what? I need a drink to sit through this gaga, this shitty gaga nonsense that I'm here for. But I mean, I digress. Luckily now we have all black pageant queens right now. That is beautiful. And I think it really does help a lot of girls see themselves in a more positive light. Now, what I find really, really interesting is there are a lot of people that are going to find negative things to say about these girls. There's been people saying really negative things about Miss Universe or have said negative things about any of the other girls who have won these pageants. And it's just like, I don't understand what black people want. Like, I don't. Like, black people want inclusivity. They want to be showcased more. And then you showcase one black person.
Oh, she ain't got her real hair out. Ooh, she light skin. Oh my god, but she's mixed.
Bitch, all I wanna see is a little bit of color. That's all I care about. I don't care if she's biracial, I don't care if she's light skinned, I don't care if she got a 20-inch Brazilian weave. Would I prefer that she was dark skinned with 4C hair? Yes. However, black is black to me. I don't give a shit, okay? I just need girls of color in the media so we have more representation one way or another, okay? Not all black people are dark skin or brown skin, okay? Some of us are light skin and not mixed. I don't understand why that's so hard for some people to understand. Like, I just can't. Some of us have loose texture hair and are not mixed. Like, why is that so hard for people to understand? Why is that so hard for people to grasp? Like, for whatever reason, I feel like a lot of black people find a way to, like, create segregation, create problems. It's like, they're all black, what more do you want? Like, I just can't. I'm just happy they're all black. I'm happy that a lot of black girls now can look at a TV screen or look at these pageants and be like, hey, yay, I'm represented. This beautiful black girl has won. This beautiful black girl represents me. If she can do it, I can do it too. Now, that doesn't just mean pageants. I mean that goes with education. That goes with starting a business. That goes with everything. Because we don't just need girls doing pageants. We don't just need girls in school. We need girls starting businesses. We need female judges. We need female officers. We need female everything, especially black ones. There's not enough black women doing authoritative things. There's not enough black women in the media spotlight, in the beauty spotlight, in the pageant spotlight. So now it's beautiful to see, like, oh my God, like, they killing it out here. They killing it. Let me know down in the comment section below, have you been to a pageant? Do you want to attend a pageant? Do you want to be in a pageant? Because honestly, I'm over it. I enjoy watching them, like Topless and Tiara type shit, but other than that, I'm not going to any more goddamn pageant. I don't care for it. I really, truly don't. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'ma see y'all next time.